on this episode of Stuff That You Can Just Have, no really, it's just growing and you can just eat it, we're going to identify, prepare, and taste the amber jelly roll fungus. If you are a beginner, I highly recommend learning this mushroom because it is very common, has a long season, is easy to find and recognize, and has no poisonous lookalikes in North America. In fact, this is actually the first wild edible mushroom that I ever found identified and ate myself. In this video, I'll be referring to these as mushrooms just because it's easy, but technically, scientifically, they are not a true mushroom. They are within a group known simply as jelly fungus. That's because, unlike most mushrooms, which are Homo basidiomycetes, these fungus are hetero basidiomycetes, and I would love to get more into that, but we just don't have time. No, really, I definitely understand exactly what that means, and I could go on at length about it, but we are really just so pressed for time, so let's move on. These mushrooms can be found growing on dead twigs and branches during autumn, winter, and spring. It specifically will grow only on smaller pieces of wood. I've never seen it growing on a thick log, and online sources seem to back this observation. Its favorite trees are willow, poplar, alder, and prunus species, which include cherry, plum, peach, and almonds. Actually, it was first identified in Germany growing on a willow tree. Around here, I feel like I see them on black cherry tree branches, but definitely also willow trees. The way to identify these is simple. If you find weird, squishy, rubbery fungus growing on a dead twig or branch, and it is either this color and shaped like this, or black in color and shaped like a button, you're good. Obviously, make sure that you have an expert help you, and make sure you're 100% sure whenever you're going to eat something. Don't go just by this, but this is seriously the easiest mushroom to identify. Every beginner should learn it. But when you hold them up to the light, you can see they're kind of translucent, so that's another way to tell. It's pretty common to find these growing on a twig or a branch on the ground, because when you're foraging, that's where your eyes tend to be. But the main place that these mushrooms actually grow is on dead branches or twigs that are still attached to the standing wood. So when you find a branch full of these on the ground, go ahead, pick them, but then look up. Chances are you'll see a ton more. I'm sorry for the grainy dark footage here, but it's really hard to get detail with your camera pointed at the sky. But here's some slightly better footage. This is a willow branch along an inland lake that is just loaded with amber jelly roll mushrooms. To answer your question, yes, I really wanted to climb out there and pick some because I'm acutely aware of how entertaining that would have been for you, but this was early May and the water temperatures were still pretty low and it was a cold day and we were kind of a long walk from the van, and if ever a thick tree branch were to break on you, it would be this one that you know is dead because it's covered in a fungus that specifically eats dead tree branches. So I got talked out of it, but it honestly wasn't that hard to talk me out of it. So how do you cook these strange gelatinous mushrooms? So first of all, clean them up, and then it is imperative, no matter what else you have planned, that you saute them. Not for any culinary reason, but because if you went to all this trouble, you got to see them dance around in the pan and go flying and stuff. Seriously, you can just toss clean jelly fungus into any soup or stew without ceremony or pretense, and it'll add a nice gelatinous sort of chewy interesting texture, but that wouldn't be any fun. So instead, we're going to make a creamy bay scallop and jelly fungus spaghetti. I have to credit the original OG chef of YouTube, Chef John, for this recipe. We basically just took his creamy bay scallop spaghetti recipe and added jelly roll fungus. I can't praise Chef John enough. He's got like 1,000 great recipes on his channel, and most of them are super simple, and they're adaptable, and there's not too many ingredients. But anyway, let's cook. You can find all the ingredients for our recipe in the description. So anyway, first clean your amber jelly roll fungus, then be sure to gather any children that have been entrusted to your care, and saute your jelly roll fungus in butter or a high smoke point oil like canola or avocado oil or what have you. And they're done whenever you've watched enough of them go flying. When you are done frying the mushrooms, remove and reserve them. Meanwhile, boil some salty water and cook your spaghetti for about 1 minute less than the minimum length on the package. We're undercooking our pasta so we can finish it in the sauce. That way our noodles will soak up some flavor and we can get some pasta starch into our sauce to thicken it. So make sure you save some pasta water when you drain in case you want a thicker sauce. Add your scallops to the hot pan you fried the mushrooms in, making sure to first add some more oil if needed, and don't crowd them. Do batches if you need to. Sear at high heat for about a minute. Toss them around. Then add your butter and stir the scallops until it melts. And then you're going to stir in your garlic, red pepper flakes, add lemon zest, stir in the sherry or whatever cooking wine you're using. You can get away with a pretty wide range of cooking wines on this one. And when I say cooking wine, I mean wine that you're cooking with. I don't mean the stuff that says cooking wine on the bottle. Anyway, you cook and stir all that until the alcohol cooks off, and that'll take about a minute. And then you're going to put in some heavy cream. Do not skimp on this. You just had a hard day in the woods picking mushrooms, so just treat yourself to some heavy whipping cream. Don't ask me if you can do this with milk. The answer is probably yes, but just shut up and put heavy cream in it. And then bring it up to a simmer. Once you're at a simmer, then you're going to bring the heat down to medium-low. You're going to add salt, pepper, and lemon juice. And then you're going to add your cooked pasta and mushrooms back in, along with some fresh herbs like parsley or maybe some wild garlic mustard that you picked. And then you're going to simmer that until the pasta is fully cooked, which should take just about a minute. And then you're going to grate some parm on there if you got it, and maybe some more of those fresh herbs, and that's it. My hand model did such an amazing job plating this up, so you'll just have to indulge me here with all this B-roll of the finished dish. I'm sorry, you're just going to have to watch. All right, enough of that. Let's taste it. Oh boy, does this look good. This is not my first time with the amber jelly roll fungus. But I'm sure, like, what you guys are really curious about is how is this weird gelatinous mushroom taste? And I haven't cooked it like this before, so I will taste this on its own first, just for you guys at home. That's really good. It's kind of tender. It's not really chewy, but it's like if some meat thing was chewy, but it wasn't chewy. It was soft. It's kind of like. But I want some more lemon juice, and I'm just going to wait here until some arrives and just see if you guys will bring me some lemon juice if I sit here and talk about it long enough. Oh my goodness. Thanks, YouTube. I love lemons. I just love lemon juice, and I'm just going to lemon juice the crap out of this. And so let's try it with a little bit more lemon juice. All right, and that's what I'm talking about. It's excellent. You just adjust the salt and lemon juice to your taste. And this is great. Pretty easy to throw together after a hike or something. Assuming you have heavy cream in the house, everything else is a pretty common ingredient. You could pretty easily just throw whatever mushrooms you found. But anyway, yeah, I'm going to eat this off camera. And I'm going to enjoy it. And thanks for watching.